Hello again. Here I am again. Okay, yeah, I just finished this and I had the sketch for a long time and I'm going to use it for an exhibition in a couple of days in my home island, Karmøy. And there's not much to say actually. Usually I go more detail, but I let this be a little bit more impressionist. You can see the brush strokes and stuff are kind of more swoosh, and the details are a little bit more diluted. Then again, how much detail do we actually need? See the yellows are popping out, but not really like that in real life. So I think this came quite nice. Maybe we should try to put on some more light. See. Ah, shit. So there we are. I think it became quite good depth in it, and the light is very nice, and maybe someone wants to have it on their wall. Yeah, and the framing, expensive framing. So I can see here how it's painted. That is what I like with paintings, that they are painted. I like to see the strokes and brushwork of the artist. So that's why I like Rembrandt so much, the later Rembrandt. Anyway, so thank you for watching, and remember to subscribe and share my videos and leave a comment if you want to. That would be nice. Tell me what you think. So, if you want to ask me questions, you can just comment and ask, and I will answer you. Okay. So, hello, viewers. I was thinking about showing you how to what I do when I restart from a sketch that has dried. I have a painting here that I'm going to show you. This one, it's a landscape with actually my daughter in when she was, I think she was 9 or 10. What I do when I start working with it again, because it has been drying for quite a while, and I'm going to start molding it. And what I do is to put on first, I put on this retouché furnace, and then some color to get the textures to come out and have something to, in a way, restart the whole process. Well, I'm gonna show you, so you can just keep on watching. So here I am. So the first thing I do is I take this retouché furnace, and since it has dried, all the colors are kind of dried, and I can't really see the colors because it's so dry. And so that's why I do this, to see how it kind of brings out the contrasts on the canvas. So it's easier to work on top of it. Now this is a very nice sketch. I'll probably sketch, some people would maybe even call it a finished painting, but I think it's, that would be too easy. And what happened for a while is lose all this just to kind of get it back in a different form, more clear. Based on turpentine and Damar Harpix. Smells really good. I don't know how healthy it is. So it's just got to dry for a little while and I'll just keep working on it.
Okay, I'm gonna show you the next.
Okay, so now that it's dried a little bit, kind of a sticky, but it's okay. What I do now is I take a lot of this medium, 70% turpentine and 30% cooked linseed oil. I make almost like an aquarelle. Make it very thin, a lot of oil, and then I do something that can horrify people. I just go over it like this, and I do this because I want the textures. You see, I just kind of fuck it up. Go over the whole thing, and what happens is that the colors now kind of fall into all the cracks, all the brush strokes. And it's quite important to give it that it's kind of dried if you work on it as hard as I do now. Usually I have a bigger brush and I go over the whole painting. But I'm gonna work on this spot now, so I'll only do it here. Now, it also brings out more shape and more, as I said, textures and contrasts. Now, this kind of seemed a little bit too much, but I don't use so much oil when I don't put so much oil on when I start painting. Now, this was just the first step. And what I do now is that I start taking away again. I need some paper. Away most of it so it's not too oily, but I kind of keep the depth I got from the, I keep get all these textures and I see it, and the oil is kind of now inside all the textures, all the as I said, bumps and lumps. If you look at the old master paintings, you can see all the brush strokes and you can see all these thin layers of color on top of the thick ones, and you can see
how the whole dynamic of the different layers are kind of making this beautiful natural feel to them. If you only lay one layer, it will just be flat. Yeah, I don't like that. Anyway, what I do now is that I start scrape away more of the excess cover. Scrape away and put some of the lightest points will now start coming back here. So, okay, and now, in a way, this oil thing has also mixed with the retouché fumes, so it's not actually wet, it's just the color in there. So yeah, so this was step number two. Now step number three is start painting. I'm gonna do that for a while, and yeah, okay, so step three. Okay, building light. You always want to build it like a sculpture, as I've said probably a gazillion times before. I always start with a fresh palette. I have many of these. I just start a new one every day. If you have more colors left, you can actually keep them in the fridge, on a mirror or something, and they won't dry as fast. Anyway, what I do now is to start with these points of light, which I start with these points of light again, which I kind of ruined. And that's a bad one. Need a better one. I need a bigger one. Keep your tools close, and yeah. Anyway, point is, I want to start with face, just with these points, which I just went over, so I get them back. These points are here. I will start filling them in later. Not now. The nose. Need better tools. So brushes. So you want to just keep going, blending colors. Not actually blending, more like grabbing. Now there are some, now it is kind of a bluish thing. So what I can do now is just get the shadows out. No, the light points out, because the thin layer of color now is kind of strengthening the shadow parts, so it's easier for me to pull out light. Eventually I will go over that too, but it kind of leaves me with a easier task. Kind of like this, I think. The nose is very bright because there's a sunbeam hitting it right here. And has this skin in this has a very reddish orange tone to it, because it was taken in the evening. Photographs were taken in the evening with my Pentax Aziz 6-7 with the tungsten film. And yeah, so there has a lot of, yeah, so I've been wondering doing some live screening and live painting real time on Twitch or YouTube. Just see what happens. I have to get the right equipment. Yeah, but I noticed that I have a hard time really concentrating about the painting when I'm talking. So I have to figure out a way to paint and then take pauses so I can answer people's questions. Anyways, just to bring out the light. So now there are some beautiful light sources in her fingers here that I really finger actually touches her face, which is very nice. You see, also using my fingers a little bit when I do some. They say that William Turner used his nails and his fingers and his, yeah, you know what, and probably not his penis, but and a nail can actually be a nice tool. It's like a knife in a way, you have just better control over it. You see now, I'm not gonna drag this light. What I do now is that I go in here and I kind of fish it out like this. Because she's holding her hand like that, and you're getting this. Many people would do like this, and it doesn't give the same feel to it, because everything in nature or in the universe are shapes, and they have some kind of, seems to me anyway, they have some kind of direction to them. Landscape is like this way, or the sky is like this way, or just how it feels. Well, that's how it feels to me. I don't think it's scientific. The universe is just mathematics anyway. Mathematics and matter. Now, you see, I've dragged it down. To get more shadow here, I can do it a little bit different way. We'll also drag it a little bit down there, like this, but I prefer to go in with different directions, which in the end, of course, disappears because, or not disappears, but painted over again and again and again, so it becomes a more holistic painting. No. Holistic, I don't know the word. So I drag like this. And I always keep building the thickest parts. I build more and more and more, so that in the end I get this sculptural feeling to it. Flat paintings are so boring. I want there to be some texture and something that actually shows that we're an artist there. I mean, if you want to paint paintings that look like prints, well, what's the point, really? I like there to be some paintedness to them. You see the light coming, starting to come back on. There's a bone here, so just mark that. Now I need to go back to the color I used as in the beginning, and I just start creating this round shadow thing. And then I also see this is a landscape, and there's a small house in the background, and the sun is actually hitting that house, and it's right over her shoulder. So there's a small light, point of light just behind her shoulder hair. That kind of brings out the shape. So of course be calmed more down after a while, and I will paint the greens in the background, everything, strengthen. And how many colors you use in every painting is actually compared to what you are painting. When I'm using a photograph, it is limited to the colors in the photograph. I don't try to add anything or take anything away. I just try to paint what I see and use it as a way to mold it. Blah blah blah. A friend of mine tells me that I'm talking too much, and I probably do. But then again, that's me, so here I am. See, I use the background here, the landscape, to explain shoulder. Not shoulder, I mean, this one. And also in the background, you have the kind of greenish, bluish, deeper sky. It also is used to get her kind of come out of the painting. As you see, the sky down here, very far, far back there, but and I try to keep it down, but right here where you have right behind her head, you can actually use some texture and sculptural paint to bring it out. It goes all the way down here. Kind of mixes with this. Yeah. And then you can just, there's a couple of hairs. Just put them back on again. Do some. And you can bring her out. But then, what is amazing to do is doing the lightest parts. They are so bright. Thick. And I just go in here and I just start to get the color, and you see I'm drying it down now. And I will also go this way because there are different. When you have a fold that goes that way, you can do it like this, and in between them you just go like this. So differentiate these two from each other. Here's the kind of reddish color, which means that the shadows are kind of bluish reddish maybe in there. There's a saying, you have to kill your darlings, and that is exactly what you have to do over and over again. When you paint, I'm going to try to create a painting. I see people put in all the details way too early, and it's really not necessary, because if you're gonna create a good painting, you have to paint over it again and again anyway. So what's the point? Anyway, you can do it if you like, but you have to paint. So now, let's see here. She has some blondes in there. It's kind of flowery things that I would put on much later. When I do that, I will talk a little bit about how I make things look a little bit fluid, like a aquarellish feel to it. But that's in a different part of this video. To concentrate, so I'm gonna turn off the camera and next time you see it, it's a jump in space and time. If I can now tear myself away from it, which always are difficult when you are getting into it. And there's a, that is nice, you have to see this. Sun is actually hitting behind here in a small strip that goes on like this. Now, of course, it was too much. Is. okay. Almost okay. Ah! Okay, I hope this one a little bit instructive. Okay. So, as you see, I'm getting further into it, and yeah. So what I do now, it's kind of go back and forth here. So I'm getting these, painting the clothes texture. I'm downloading some shit. My computer is making noise. See, I go that way now because when this I go, I change and it's gonna be more in the background, so I have to keep it down. I'm not putting on any thick layers behind there. Only thick layer is gonna be down there, that cloth. This way. So there was some greenish. Actually, what I use here is a lot of Prussian blue, and I mix it with other bluish colors and some a little bit of black, and putting in some reddish and the greenish. Appears as a consequence of all the reddish or the warm colors in the cloth and in the skin, because the sun actually came in and hit her directly. So, and of course I did that on purpose when I took these photographs many years ago. I took these photographs now. Keep on coming back there. It was quite nice, and they have been quite popular. So, follow the shape now to so get it right. Then I keep on going over it again and again, so in the end everything just glides into everything else. Like this. As I said a gazillion times before, there's only one way to learn how to paint, and that is to do the work and learn by your own mistakes. What I can do is only point you in some direction.
and
I also, of course, recommend oil paint.
Yeah. So here I am working with the face, fingers, face, and some detail. I have gone over the painting with the dress and stuff, but I need to do these things before I start working on the surroundings. I always have to start with, if I'm going to do some detail, I always have to start with the details first, because this is the most exhausting thing. And you want to be at your best when you do. So surroundings are more relative, really. But things like faces and hands and stuff like that is not that relative. Well, it's not really relative at all, but I guess you know what I mean. So that's what I'm doing now. Because this is a new thing that I've seen, it's called slow TV. And actually, President Obama was talking about it in a speech when he was in this party with the Norwegian government. And he said in Norway, we have programs where you can watch a boat or a train traveling, and that's it. It's called slow TV. I guess this is kind of slow TV in a way. Maybe we should start streaming or something. Start doing slow TV. There will be more layers, so it's just to get it right. Thing is that in the end things just have to fade into one another, and you can't really do that in one go, because it will turn into mush. It won't be a pretty picture. So has to be built gradually. Mm-hmm. Now it's hard for me to get the right perspective when I'm making the videos, because I'm seeing it straight in and you're seeing it from, so it may get a little bit strange angle. But to do something just after live with, I guess.
27 degrees in Oslo today. That's hot even in here, and it's a cellar place, and usually it's not hot on here. Today it actually is. Here I just away, and it gets a more natural feel to it. Longer, it's the same mark, it's a Da Vinci. It's better quality, but I just need to actually used this on work over here, and that was a problem because I keep on bumping into it, and you shouldn't do that. You should plan the painting better, so you don't actually gonna paint here, you paint here, and then you paint there, because it's gonna be a mess. Well, no, how is this for a Muslim artist? I mean, this is pig's hair, and is that haram? Really hate religion, it makes so many false assumptions. God hates ham, yeah, right. Of course that must be true. I mean, of course God hates ham. I mean, why not create an animal that you hate, or you tell humans that they are supposed to hate? So much bullshit in the world. So sad. Reminds me of the series Battlestar Galactica, when the last series, they went a couple, 2 or 3 years ago, 4 years ago, well, anyway, almost all of humanity is wiped out, and they have some spacecraft floating around fighting the Cylons, and then they start arguing among each other and start killing each other instead of fighting the enemy and making babies. And it's kind of what humans do. We fight each other for absolutely no good reasons at all. And we are ruining the habitat, our habitat. And we are floating around the sun. It's a hydrogen fusion machine. Big nuclear explosion. And we are bickering about bullshit. Just fucking bullshit. Makes me angry. Yeah. Zoom und hier okay, oops. So glad that as I grow older, I enjoy more and more being alone, just doing my work, not having lots of noise. In my head all the time, telling me to go out and party and find girls, just relax and enjoy the ride. And that's what I'm gonna do till I drop. Yeah, okay. Later. Yeah. Well, I'm working on a background now, and there's some houses in the background, and I'm trying to keep them loose and keep them in the distance. And then I'm gonna go close with a video when I'm finished with it and just talk a little bit about it. But it's all only like grabbing color and thinking like an impressionist, the impressionists, and put on lights, and you see that the light is coming that way, so you have to get the, but then again you don't want that light to be as bright as this light, so you have to kind of keep it down with the hue or the color. That is also what you do when you put a lazur. You see, I'm just touching it, directions, and you don't want everything to, all the light, you know, this light is in the distance, it's actually the same as in the universe. If you see distant stars, the red light shift changes compared to the distance and the speed. And it's the same principle on Earth, in nature. It's like shadows. Now it's obvious, must be obvious, why I can't show you the whole paint process. I have been wondering about starting to stream on Twits or on YouTube, and people could maybe donate and ask me questions. Like, if you want to donate, like $1 to $1 million, it doesn't matter. It's just a token. If you feel you learned something from my videos. But you don't have to, you can ask me questions. I'm happy to answer all your questions. It's kind of my contribution to, my small contribution to humanity. If you know what I mean. Give something back, as Arnold Schwarzenegger said. Give something back. Yeah. Anyway, the point is, I'm going to do some in the background, and when I do this, is you don't want a sky that is too perfect. You want it to live a little bit. So these pencils, these or brushes. The boar shit, Christine shit. Well, welcome to my life. You don't want it to be too perfect, and these brushes are giving you some texture. When you put on the colors, you have to work back and forth, and you kind of push colors into one another. You get all these strokes. I'm kind of mixing the color on the canvas. First it's too bright, and then I just maybe a little bit of oil. This is how I go over the whole thing. Now it's quite dry here, so I have to work with it a while until it kind of, I find the right tone. And that's what I do. I work on it until I find the right tone. But you don't want to use these feather brushes. If you want a very nice painted surface, you don't want these feather, like the ones you just brush everything out, and it becomes this, it looks nice, but it doesn't rock, it doesn't do anything, and it's so fucking boring. You need to get to live like the sky. The sky has many colors in the sky. It's reddish, and it's green, and it's red, and it's orange, and it's yellow, and it's compare how down here is more reddish, then it's kind of greenish, and then go over to a brighter blue, and there's so many colors, and you have to just try to see that and understand how it works. Just like this.
because I was working on this last night, and it actually is so thin that it's almost dry, and then that is why when you work on a sky like this, or a whole, or work on things around the model, around the figure, try to put in many hours so you can go over the whole thing in one go, because when the color is wet, it's easier to kind of mold all the different colors, to get them crisscross. When I get it dry, I can actually start molding like this again. No, I mean, sorry, make it not dry, but wet. I'm Norwegian, it's my second language. I wasn't good at school. I was good in talking, I could talk English, but I couldn't write it. So, but I can hear that my vocabulary isn't as good as it should be, so maybe I should start reading more books and get better at it. It's easier to communicate when you actually know the language. The lingo. Most Norwegians, I mean, the politicians are horrible to listen to when they're talking. Even the Prime Minister is just a little. I'm listening to tons of science lectures and documentaries and stuff. So I guess I've learned my English through watching movies, documentaries, audiobooks. I'm a dyslexic, partly dyslexic, also write with both my hands. So when I come, actually, this doesn't work for me. I was wondering, starting to train, since I can write with both my hands, I should be able to paint with both my hands. But I mean, the brain connects the neurons compared to what you do. So I could actually learn it. I used to weld, I was a welder, and I used to weld with both hands. And yeah, I've got some white. Should try. I think I'm gonna buy myself a piano. Start learning how to play the piano. I'm thinking about it for many, many years, like 15 years, since I saw the Gary Oldman and just saw Gary Oldman play Beethoven. It's a beautiful movie. Recommended Gary Oldman as Beethoven. It's a beautiful movie. Anyway, and I love Rachmaninoff, and I love all the classics. And so I would like to find out how to do it. I should just buy one and start. I know nothing, next to nothing. But if I could go from welder to painter, like a little bit over 20 years, with all the partying and a waste of time that I used to do, should be able to learn how to play the piano. Yeah! Blah blah blah. I feel great actually, and yeah.
So, this short video is, as long as it didn't become so short, but this video is a part of a bigger one, so you just have to watch it. So, now it's a little bit more, been painting for a while, and it's more fluid. When you put on color, it's more susceptible to take in more colors. So remember to be careful with black, because I don't use any black in the sky. Not to suppress the colors or anything. I use reds, and I use the anisarine and kraplak, as it's called, to break them down, and I mix them together so I get in kind of a deeper tone like this. People tell me that they like the light in my paintings, and it kind of comes down to how you use the colors. You have to use the colors as nature does, but understand how shadows appear out of the primary colors. Light until dark and stuff. I'm actually going to paint on the other painting now for 6 hours. The Victoria with red rose, red wild rose. So I'm going to let this dry for a couple of days, and then I'm going to go over it again. Maybe I should make some fast-forward versions of these videos, because people's interest span is quite short. The shorter the video, the more views. Not really always true, though. The Victoria video with the red rose, red wild rose, has been seen now almost 130,000 times, and it is probably 3 hours long, 2 or 3 hours long, 2 hours long, I think. And there's a new, and the second part is coming out now to a YouTube near you. So the next layers, the last layers I do is when I make all the lines disappear into the background, and I start to cross over to soften the lines, but I also let some lines be hard, so it kind of gives it that 3D feeling. I think too many of the figurative paintings are too much inside, and or so the figures and the colors always feels like they are behind a glass wall or something, and I like them to be more real, more come out and get you. So that is what he said about the night watch when it was finished, that the spear looked like it came out of the painting, and it's because Rembrandt used the colors in the correct way, and he put them up against each other, the yellows and reds, and he put them up against each other in a way that gave it that 3D illusion. Brilliant, brilliantly done. And if you understand that, you can come quite a long way. As far as Rembrandt, but if you can touch on it in a lifetime, you should be pleased with yourself. Yeah. And yeah, that was the thing. It's darker over here because the light is hitting here. So in this end, I make the sky a little, give it a little bit more texture, so it's not just the color or the temperature and but it's also the texture that I give a little bit more. I kind of pencil it more out here than I do there, and to kind of get get it into the physical space too, or whatever you would say. So that's why I use the pencil. The pressure on the pencil is also different to what you do. If I want to put it in, I push a little bit harder. If I wanted to come more out, I kind of take thicker layers and just swoosh, keep mold them. So maybe that's why I want to learn how to play the piano, because I know the pressure on the tangents, whatever we call it, is what make it personal. Every pianist has his own way of putting in the pressure and the weight on the piano. Anyway, I think I'm gonna leave it alone now. Too bright over here. Switch things. Yeah, I'm gonna film a little bit closer when I do the details, so you can see how it's done. So with this, let's stop now, and until next time. So today I'm going to do the last layer. So I start with my lasur, and I use my bluish, some reddish, kaplak, or even cadmium red, and I just go over it like this to get it to live a little and to get it down to a different level. We'll see now it kind of calms down a little bit. Of course, I take away much of this afterwards and scrape it away. But it's going to make more depth and some texture to work with. I'm probably going to use like 8 hours or something for the whole thing. Of course, I'm not going to tape it all. It would be a nightmare. So I just push down. Just give it a little reddish hue. What one can do is to also with these lazur layers, I can just now have some aquarellish feel to it. You can actually go over a painting after you have finished it and go in with these aquarelle, almost aquarelle. Of course, it's oil, it's this mixture between my linen oil, cooked linen oil and turpentine. It's 70% turpentine. Now I just want maybe a little bit there, but in the shadow I can also go in and give it some more spooning space. So then go in and I just take away some oil just to snow not that much oil. Sounds brutal. Now you see more textures are coming. You can see the brush strokes more. I was in a Frick museum in New York and looked at Turner. And yes, he has done some of these things. Because when you go in and you look at the different layers and different depths, so you can actually see them in that way. It's spot. Okay. So, okay. I'm going to start. Now, when you start a new layer, I'm going to do this. I have a totally clean palette. See this? I just cleaned it with turpentine. I just clean it all the way so it's dry, and I just put on new color, and I do this maybe two or three times every day. I change the palettes and stuff because it gets greasy after a while, and then you just lose control. So. So don't do that. You see, I've been painting for 6 or 7 hours now. You see the other palettes, some are used, it's like crazy. So when I keep on painting on this, I just go back, and after this becomes more messy, I just take the colors from the other palette so we can actually get use the color and don't waste it. It's quite expensive color, but white actually. Knew there was something missing. So, now we are talking. So where to begin? Well, I just begin somewhere and I just start painting, and then I go into the flow. And the rest just now in these layers, I'm gonna keep this down, so then I'm using the brush more like I'm not giving it too much texture. All the texture are in the light areas, and this way you create both space in the physical and just nuances and shadows and different colors. And I actually never learned to paint from by anyone, so I learned by the by intuition and doing a lot of mistakes. So I guess I still do a lot of mistakes that I don't even know about, but I maybe in 1 year or 2 years, 5 years or 10 years, I will see, oh shit, I should have done like this. But then again, it's the best way to learn, to actually just fail. Fail, 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 and fail, fail, fail. That's the way to learn. Of course, studying some color circle and stuff like that could be also helpful. But when it comes to painting, when it comes to doing it, you have to do it to understand. Now, this mustn't be too blue, because this is very blue, so down here has to be more in the warm greenish, bluish, green, reddish, orange. We have blue, there is always orange somewhere. You have red, the green is around, you just have to spot it. See now, it gets a little bit prettier. So, there's some clouds up there, they're quite reddish actually. To give everything shape. The cloud has color, it isn't white. I see a lot of people, amateur painters, they always, it's the cloud. Don't paint symbols. You have a symbol in your head called cloud. Don't go there. Look at how it is. Look at the nuances, look at everything. Have a symbolic brain, a brain who remembers by symbols. And then the house over there is quite red, but it's also warm. Some more punch, vividness. That's with my painting. I never learned to paint by a bomb, so I do go a little bit crazy in the colors, because everything is intuition. See red, I just put on red. So it can be, I do doubt myself a lot. Okay. There's also a very bright light, it's right there. We'll give that a little bit more punch. Warm light because it's in the distance. So I do like this. Find a red color. been working now for 2 weeks. I haven't been training, I haven't been to cafes, I haven't been out, I haven't been doing anything except for painting. And now I'm starting to get a little bit, you know, the Shining movie. All work and no play. Well, I'm getting there. Usually an 8 hour day, 8 to 10 hour day would be perfect. I work 12, 14. It's way too much of a time. I even forget to eat. Maybe lose some weight. I'm going to eat some fish and some fruit today, so I need to go eat something now because of my blood sugar is dropping like crazy. And when you're really going to focus on exhibitions and stuff, you just have to go and focus on it. So I just turn my brain off. Usually I would be, it's Friday night, or Friday morning actually, it's like 5 in the morning now, and I would be so restless to go out to look at pretty girls and socialize. But just turn that off. Switch. I don't drink much though. I drink maybe once a month. Now I've been drinking since my birthday, which is almost 3 months ago. 2.5 months. So I'm gonna have an exhibition with my brother. He does photography. Now, because he can go into these things and cool details, I'm gonna have an exhibition with my small exhibition. My brother, that's my home island, Karmøy. So that's why I'm working on this. Blah blah blah. To get the point. Yo, I'm still working here. It's now 2.5 hours actually since the last video, and I'm just keep on. I had to move around some stuff. It's not that other people don't see it, but as we say, it's like morals, it's what you do when other people aren't looking, and I kind of like to have it correct, approximately correct anyway, so I don't like to take the easy way out. This one has to go in there. Damn. God, I didn't see that before. Now this one goes all the way in here. Almost anyway. So yeah. It's gonna be a mess. It because it's a real place, so it has to compute with reality. You know, the strokes and how it's painted, that it's kind of a little bit more relative, but when it comes down to getting the landscape correct and stuff, it's not something I want to compromise with. So, see. camphor down. There's no detail here, it's only impressions. So in a way it's very impressionist painted. So I try to avoid any symbols, so just try to create some dynamic shapes and colors that can, that reminds you of natural shapes. And the way I actually do that is to just keep on working on it, and the sum, in the end, the sum of all the time you touch it leaves it quite natural. Natural. So. And you don't want any sharp edges in the background. You don't want it to make it too sharp. It has to be more fluid. And things like that. Funny, I always usually film it from the other side, but it's like that. What the hell do I always do it from one side? That's strange. A man of habit. My head is so full of thoughts and stuff all the time that I have a tendency to go for the same thing, so like, I always buy the same coffee. I don't stress by buying a lot of clothes or changing my style or anything. I just stick with who I am. Yeah, I hope it becomes a little bit more depth in it. You can see that. It's very blue. Some people like that. Other people don't. My mother hates blue. I don't know why. I like it. And I look like my mom. I wish I looked like my mother, actually. She's beautiful, but I have the same kind of same personality. So strange that I love blue and she don't like blue. No, it's too blue. I don't like blue. Why do I always have to paint blue? Well, because I like blue. Oh, mother. Okay. Now, you see I'm going back and forth in this manner to kind of get the direction. See, the C is flat. If I did this, it would be wrong, okay? I'm gonna paint every wave anyway, so no, not any waves. So I'm not a photorealist, so I don't even think I would be able to. People tell me, it looks like a photo. Well, no, it doesn't. Or maybe if you take a photo and you show them on a mobile telephone or something. and you can see the textures, the colors and the strokes. It might look like a photograph. Actually, I used the photograph as a tool, so I guess if I paint from a photograph, it will look like a photograph. Because there is a difference between the paintings that I do from still life, so model, and I do from photo. So, different realities. Yes. Okay. I have a bigger room inside there. I'm going to start to paint more in there because the lighting in this room is, because of the height of the roof, quite difficult. And I might also knock a hole in that wall so I can open up that. That would be brilliant. You see, I just you know, it's like a dance on the dance floor. Okay. The greens and the reds, and I just do in a way the same thing as the impressionists did. Yeah. This my house, or people say stuff like, oh, that's my house. So funny. Just a little pretty spot, like, oh, that's my house. Well, it's not, is it? Okay, now I have to work myself down. So I'm going to pretend that I don't need to do anymore. Shit. Very important when you do this, if it's wet and wet, it's easier to create this natural transitions from background to foreground. I now it actually feels like clouds, believable clouds. Clouds we can believe in. Mm-hmm. Change, we can't believe it. Yeah, right.
So, okay. I'll work myself down. So, here I am with my palette. Maybe you want to see that a little bit. So, okay. Well, what I'm doing now is working here. I've been doing that for the last hour or 1.5 hours since I talked to you last. And what I'm doing is that now it's starting to get quite wet. So, what can happen if you work with a surface is that suddenly it dies. It loses its loses the bang, or loses what do you call it? It's not dynamic anymore. It's kind of, it dies. Like it's nothing. It's just color up and color up and color. So what one has to do is try to, I'm working it down here, it's going to be all dark here, and it's coming in, and the light, and then I'm going to work myself up there. So I always kind of structure it at this, on this level, and then I go in and make the surface wet of color, and I have to, it is strange because sometimes I actually feel that the first strokes are more dynamic, and they are, but I don't want to stop there, it would be too easy, so I'm actually killing that now. And what I have to do is first I'm going to bring it down, and then I go lightly over it again, and I bring it up again, but only on the right spots. So that is the process, and I'm trying to here. It's actually a C, but I'm not going to paint every detail, so I just need to make an impression. It would be easier if it was totally still, that the water was, or sea was totally, or the beach was totally still, but it's a little bit ripples in the water, so you don't get that glanced reflection, and when you don't have that, it's much easier and much more difficult to create that impression of water. So, kind of over here is more like in the Alessarine Kraplak, the more warm blue, like cobalt, no, not cobalt, French ultramarine. Cobalt is what I can start to mix it with Preussoble. Then I'm holding it and I just start to go over that, so I get the on the color, and I also then just lace it on top of the darkness underneath. But the Preussenblau is very cold, and the tops of waves are cold because the shadow will be, and it reflects the greenish in the sky because it's an evening sky, so it reflects that greenish, reddish greenish color. I need a French ultramarine. Maybe I should start streaming. Fuck. also use a little bit of black, but I kind of try to, you can easily kill the colors, so you have to be careful with black. Black is a very dangerous place to go because it can actually kill the whole surface if you don't use it wisely. Yeah. This is only the beginning. Some over surface. And down here, it's very warm, extremely warm. Prussian blue is extremely green, and you can, if you use some yellow in it, it becomes a really beautiful vivid color. You see, when I put it on, it's like extreme, but it's not actually gonna be on the surface right now, but just wanted to show you more, it's deeper. Well, maybe actually. That's how we find out. Then I mix in the lemon yellow in the Prussian blue. It's actually very hard to photograph these colors I use. It's always been a pain in the ass that I can't really get good photographs of my paintings because of the colors. It's easier to photograph them if you only use nuances and not so much color. So, no. It's a little bit too disturbing. So now some cobalt maybe here on top. That was wrong, totally wrong. That's what happens when you talk painting at the same time. Don't concentrate. Okay, here's gonna be more light, so no, that was wrong. Have to go more. I know it's greenish here, and it has to come into hand here. So to the inside, just drag it. Now I'm going down just to, because you don't want some parts to just come jump out of it. You don't want that. Yeah, that's better. And now I drag it that way. So and I just pull it. See, I'm mixing on the canvas actually. I'm not mixing like this, I'm mixing like, so I keep the dynamic of the colors. Now, there are some small waves here, and I just go in here, I start picking them up like this, this one over here, just gonna make this foam. Yeah. That's exactly the same process, you just have to mold it until it feels this right. I am wondering to take a couple of paintings and just go all out in detail and just use an extreme amount of time on a single painting. And I wonder if I'm just gonna have this beautiful photograph of a friend of mine and her two children, and I am wondering about making the ultimate instruction video from beginning to end, but also go total extreme in detail, try to let it become my art of painting, like the Vermeer painting. Not that I have his skills, but I can always give it a try. In for the pound. In for the pound, in for the pound. So, now the sea is actually hitting it here. So, that will automatically be darker when it kind of comes here. So to create this illusion now, this contrast between waves that break, I need to go this way, drag it. Well, this is how I'm thinking. I'm trying to think in directions all the time to get it to feel right. guess you get my point. There are breaks there, and also some lights coming here. It is funny because painting is like playing the piano, is that you have to kind of foresee the pressure on the brush, the colors, you have to learn how to foresee what happens, and that is what people are fighting in the beginning. I'm fighting it every day, but this is the main problem. And the only way of getting there is actually just paint and connect neurons in your head, so your motor skills becomes better. It is like doing martial art or whatever skill. You have to connect the neurons and train them to keep them stay connected. Because sometimes if it does a while, you stop wondering, can I really do this anymore? You know? Some strange sound in there. Maybe I'm hearing ghosts. I'm talking to an imaginary person that is in that camera. Oh shit, I'm 10 hours now. Shit. Was it 11? I don't fucking know. Anyway, these videos are becoming way too long, don't they? Anyway. Yeah. Well, I'm full of paints. The clock is now 1 in the afternoon. And I'm shit tired. And I've been painting for 14 hours. So, I think I need to get some sleep. I haven't gone over the whole thing. I guess I had to make it dry a little bit and do a little touch up. Because now all the colors are kind of turning to mush. Get the wet sand and dry sand to kind of glide together. See how light I'm holding it now. Back hurts. And I'm hungry. Well, I'm gonna leave it now and I'm gonna do a little touch up on the day. So, yeah. It's always hard to stop. That's the worst part. When to stop? Thank you. not. See how the light pops up when I do that? That's why it can be time consuming. Such small things, big impact to give it a this punch. Yeah. And there's some more light behind here. So just can't let it go. Maybe I'm feeling with me now. That's not so interesting. Little lump of sand there and give it some spatial feeling. But these are minor details, so some yellow. Some yellow. Head is silent right now. Okay. So, looks more like a beach. Some seaweed laying around. Thank you.
So, I'm doing a touch up on this painting. Now, just some minor stuff around. This is more expressionist painted, so it's not going to be that detailed. Explaining the depth. Use thin lines. You see the motions I'm using? I'm trying to get natural motion. Like in nature, the wave-like motion. So, if you get my point, yeah, exactly. What's that wave? Where does it end really? When it cuts into the shore, it's like a knife in a way. You don't really know where the edge are. It's really hard to know where to go now, because if I go further, I have to start detailing something. I have to start detailing everything. And you can't buy. It has to be an expressionist or totally clear. It can be both, in a way. Well, it can, but if I start doing a lot of details here, I have to start doing details over there. Then I'm off to a painting that will last me and continue working with it for months, not months, but weeks maybe. But that's not the point this time anyways. I keep it a little bit loose. And I have to deliver it today, so I guess just get some lights in here, my fingers.
experienced fingers. So sun is coming in here, so to have some light there. I won't feel right. A little bit more on the nose. Don't fuck it up.
It's funny because when you have almost... I was finishing it. Still life today, on a shell, in a brick, and I was talking to my father on the phone when I was painting, and I said, oh, it's finished now. Then I did something, I have no fucking clue what it was. 3 hours later, I was screaming. That was a small painting, small one. And it drove me nuts. And I'm not even sure if I see that, but I think it became okay in the end. But I had to take away a lot of colors I put on it and just start over again. And it's because I did that fucking extra brush stroke that kind of killed the, you know, when you have colors and light, you have to come to a certain point and you mustn't go over that point, or because more bright colors doesn't need more light. It's just points like that point there, just boom, it explains the elbow, and then I link them together with a line that comes down there. And now I see that because of this one can fall in, so I have to pull that one out. You know, people wouldn't see the difference, but I see the difference, and that's the whole thing about being a scientist in a way. Because a painting like this is it's not a science that I'm studying, but you have to study your own mistakes all the time. Yeah, that's better. And then in the end you reach a point where you start seeing better, seeing your mistakes, correcting them. Maybe I should put on some more light over here. Maybe that would kill this one. You can try, because the sun is really hitting that house, so you can try there. It has to be something like that, just one point, and funny, I always say when people ask me how I do it, and I always answer, I don't know, I just start and it kind of evolves. But when I'm talking to the camera, I'm actually starting to see that I am actually quite conscious of what I'm doing. It isn't all a coincidence. Here. your. If you're gonna do lasering or lasur, you have to have clean. There mustn't be any white. Right? Because then you. Everything is just dirtied up. Well, I think it became quite nice. So, okay, thank you for getting to the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something from it. It takes time to make them, so please go to my Patreon and sign up for $1 or $5 or even more if you can. Help me build up the channel by sharing it via social media. Give a thumbs up, leave a comment. Also remember, there is a small painting Patreon giveaway every month, so if you sign up, you can actually become an owner of a painting of mine.